students. Welcome back to Graduate Guru. Today we'll be doing question number 13 on the topic accounting from incomplete records. So let's read the sum. Mr. Sunny is a small trader who does not maintain accounts on double entry system. He provides us with the following data. He maintains a gross profit margin of 25% on sales. Again, our GP ratio is given. In the last few sums, we have continuously taken that GP ratio diya hai. So, GP hum calculate karenge aur kuch trading account mein amount missing hoga. So, they've given us the list of assets and liabilities as usual. Opening balance on 1st Jan 2018 and closing balance on 31st December 2018. Debtors is given, both opening and closing. Stock is given, opening diya hai, closing question mark hai. So that is what is going to be missing in our trading account. Plant and machinery, opening, closing, both amounts are same. Furniture also opening, closing, same. Creditors, they have given us both opening and closing. His rough cash book gives the following information. So this is all cash bank transactions. Due to the bank on 1st Jan 2018. Now, what does this mean? On 1st Jan, hamara opening balance hai, which is due to the bank. Hame bank ko paisa bharna hai, which means nothing but it is bank overdraft. Okay? So, this we have to be careful. Creditors is given, salaries, carriage inward and drawings. Or receipt mein hai, from debtors. So, that's your cash received from debtors and we have taken some loan from relatives. Prepare trading and P&L account and balance sheet after providing depreciation on assets at 15%. So, there are two assets. Both assets ka rate same hai, 15%. And a provision of 2% for doubtful debts. So, that we have to create a RDD, reserve for doubtful debts. Payments to creditors includes an advance of 2500 paid for booking office premises. So, ye humne creditors mein galti se dal diya hai. So, we'll have to remove it from the creditors account and we'll have to take it as an advance for office premises. Fine. So, here basically the two extra accounts that we need are debtors and creditors, which we have kept ready. Cash bank account banana padega because they've given us just a summary of the transactions. And as usual, we have trading, profit and loss and balance sheet and opening statement of affairs because that is, we don't know the opening capital. Okay, so let's begin the sum quickly. First, we have been given balances. So, sabse pehle hum opening statement of affairs bana lete hain and then we'll post the amounts. So, we have debtors, 44,000. So, asset side, I'll write debtors. That is 44,000. We also have stock of 9,500, which is our opening stock. So, stock 9,500. We have plant and machinery 10,000, furniture 700. So, wo dono bhi likh dete hain. Plant and machinery is 10,000. And furniture is 700. And then we have creditors, which will go on the liability side, 9750. So, creditors, 9750. Okay. And if you will see the cash transactions. Yahan pe kahin bhi cash bank account nahi dikh raha hai. But in the cash transactions, they have told us due to bank on the 1st Jan, that is on the first day, 3,700. So that's our bank overdraft, which we are going to record on the liability side. So bank OD or overdraft, 3,700. So, we have all our assets and liabilities. If we close this opening statement, we will get our opening capital. So, let's close our opening statement of affairs. Assets total 44,000, 9,500, and 10,700, we get a total of 64,200. We'll take it to the liability side and we'll subtract our two liabilities from that, 9750 and 3700. We get 50,750 as our opening capital. So this is our capital. Now, one by one, we will give second effect for this. This was one effect. So, iski second effect hame deni hai. Debtors, I have an account. So, I'll go to that account. To balance brought down. The amount is 44,000. Then we have stock. Ye hamara opening stock hai. Jo jayega trading account mein. So, two opening stock and the amount is 9,500. So, that is done. Then we have plant and machinery and furniture. Dono bhi assets hai. I'll take it to my balance sheet. So, in the balance sheet, I'll write it in the inner column because there is adjustment for depreciation. So, plant and machinery is 10,000. Leave a line for depreciation. And we have furniture of 700. Again, inner column and leave a line for depreciation. Okay. So, assets ho gaya. Now, going to liability. Creditors 9750. I have an account. Creditors opening balance credit side. By balance brought down. 9750. And we have bank OD of 3700. Cash bank account mein on the opposite side. By balance brought down. Because OD is a liability, so credit balance hoga. I'll write down OD 3700. Fine. Done. Capital remains. Capital goes to the balance sheet. 50,750. I'll write in the inner column because there will be some plus minus. So 50,750. So opening statement of affairs is empty. Fine. Now we go ahead with the closing balances jo ke diya hua hai. Now closing balances mein we have debtors of 50,400. First, let's record it in the account. By balance carried down. 50,400. Okay. Second effect in my balance sheet. So, balance sheet, asset side, debtors. And there is an adjustment for this also. So, I'm keeping it inside 50,400. Fine. Then we have stock. Ab stock missing hai, but I'll leave some space for it so that we don't forget it completely. So balance sheet mein asset and trading account. I'll leave space for my sales and buy closing stock. This is my missing figure. Wo baad mein hum dhoondenge. But I'm leaving it blank. Plant and machinery. 10,700. Same balances hai which we have already written. Isme depreciation adjust hoga later on. And creditors. Creditors I'll first write in the account. Amount is 19,500. So, two balance carried down. 19,500. And second effect in the balance sheet. Leave space for capital. And creditors, 19,500. Okay. So, closing balances also we've done two two effects. Now, we'll go to the cash summary. Cash book ka jo bhi transactions diya hai. Due to bank, the bank OD tha, we already gave two effects. Done. Now, we have creditors. Obviously, we've paid to the creditors. So creditors mein, creditors account debit to cash bank account. The amount given is 12,500. Second effect, in my cash bank, by creditors, 12,500. That is done. Then we have paid salaries. Salaries, cash bank mein payment hai. So, on the credit side, by salaries, amount given is 5,000 and this is our expense. So, second effect jayega P&L mein, debit side pe, two salaries, 5,000. That is done. Next is carriage inward. Again, payment. So, I will write it here first in the cash bank account by carriage inward. Amount is 7750. Second effect, trading account, it's our expense. So, you leave space for purchases. Two carriage inward. Okay, so that's done. Then we have drawings. पहले यहां पे लिख देते हैं drawings of 1500 these are all payments so on the payment side second effect in my sorry balance sheet over here minus drawings 1500 we can subtract and write in the inner column. So, I'll do that calculation. 5750 minus 1500. 49250 is our balance. And then we have two receipts from debtors first. So, on the receipt side, two debtors, 30,000 is given. Okay. Debtors hai, so second effect debtors mein by cash bank 30,000 and we have taken a loan from the relative 2,500. So first in the cash bank to loan from relative 2,500 or loan liability hai, to liability side pe loan from relative 2,500. Okay, so cash bank also done, two effects given. Now they have said depreciation on assets. So, ek by ek asset pe depreciation karte hai, rate is 15%. So, minus depreciation, 10,000 ka 15% will be 1,500. Minus karke I get 8,500 and 700 pe 15% will be 105. Minus karke we get 595. Okay, let's record the depreciations in the profit and loss account. So, profit and loss, expense side to depreciation. Both assets separate. So, plant and machinery. First, 1500. And furniture, 105. So, we have both the depreciations also done. Then they have said provision of 2% for doubtful debts. So, debtors may minus RDD reserve for doubtful debts, that is 50,400 into 2%, we have 1008. Minus karke I have 49,392. This is also our expense. Agar bad debts vagera sab diya hai, to we make a format. Two bad debts, add further bad debts, add new reserve. But wo sab nahi hai. So only the RDD will go as my expense. So P&L to RDD on debtors 1008. So these things are also done. Now there is one last adjustment which says payments to creditors includes an advance paid for booking office premises. Amount is 2500. Jab humne creditors ko pay kiya, wo pura amount yahan pe aa gaya. I want to remove it from this. So agar maine use debit side pe likha hai, use cancel karne ya remove karne ke liye, I have to give an entry on the credit side. So I will write by advance for office premises. Amount is 2500. Because this is not a part of my creditors. So I am removing it. Now this is an advance given for something. This becomes my asset. Kisi bhi cheez ke liye hum advance dete hain, it comes in under my asset. So in my asset, advance for office premises 2500. Okay. Now let's start closing the accounts. Okay. Debtors, we have opening, closing and cash jo pay kiya hai. What is missing is my credit sales. Let's calculate that. Credit side total, I will get 80,400. Let's subtract our debit from that. So 80,400 minus 44, we get our credit sales as 36,400. Okay. Where do we take that? Trading account. So in the trading account, buy sales. There is no mention of cash sales. So obviously, all the sales are only going to be credit. 36,400. Okay. Same way, we'll close creditors. Jo basic amounts hai, wo hai humare paas. Opening, closing and cash bank. This is an extra adjustment. Anyway, what we'll get now after we close the account is our credit purchases. So over here on this side, I'll get my credit purchases. Let's calculate. 12,500 plus 19,500, we get 32,000. Subtract the other two amounts, 9,750 and 2,500. So I get 19,750 as my credit purchase. Again, second effect, trading account, two purchases. Credit 19,750. Okay. So our working notes are closed. Debtors and creditors. Let's go to cash bank. Opening balance OD tha. Baki payments and receipts are given to us. We don't have a closing balance. So let's find our closing balance. This side is heavier. We have 32,500 on the debit side. Let's calculate our balance. 32,500 minus 3,700, 12,500, 5,000, 7750 and 1500, I get 2050. That's my closing balance. Now we have to decide whether this is positive balance or negative balance. If cash is an asset, if there was a positive opening balance, toh debit pe rehta. So positive closing balance will be on the credit. Okay. So this is a positive balance. It's a cash balance which will go on my asset side. So cash bank 2050. Okay. This is also done. Now I have to start closing my trading. But to close my trading, I should have all the amounts. Tab hum GP dhoond sakte hain. But yahan par closing stock missing hai. And that is why I have to go back to the first line of the sum, which told me that the GP ratio is 25% on sales. So let's do a small working here. I have to calculate my gross profit. GP ratio diya hai 25% on sales. Agar sales missing hai, toh we calculate cost. But yahan par sales already hai hamare paas, which is 36,400. So directly uska 25% will be my GP. So GP is equal to 36,400 into 25%. Let's calculate that. 36,400 into 25%. We get 9,100 as our GP. So let's take that to our trading. To gross profit. And this we have got from our working note. 9,100. Now when we close the trading account, we will get the missing figure, which is our closing stock. So let's take our debit side total. 9,500, 19,750, 7,750 and 9,100. I get 46,100. I bring that on this side. Minus my sales, 36,400. We get a closing stock of 9,700. Wo hum lekar jayenge here where we've left it blank in my asset stock, 9,700. Okay. GP I have calculated. Wo hum PNL mein lekar jayenge. So by gross profit, 9,100. And now let's close our P&L to find our net profit. This side is heavy, so I'll write that on both the sides. 9,100 minus karte hai. 1,500, 105 and 1008. We get 1487 as our net profit. We'll take that to our balance sheet and add it to the capital. Add net profit 1487. Let's add that to our 49,250. We get 57,37. Ab total kar lete hain. 19,500 and 2,500. 72,737 is the total of liabilities. Let's see if it's the same for assets. 595,49,392, 9,700, 2,500 and 2,050. Yes, our balance sheet is tallying at 72,737. So here again, something different in this sum. Closing stock missing tha. So again we had to find our gross profit and then calculate the closing stock. So take down this sum and then we'll go ahead further. Let's move to question number 14. Mr. Raju maintains books on single entry system. From the following information, prepare his final accounts for the year ended 31st March 2019. Machinery diya hai, opening balance hai, closing is missing, jo hum depreciation ke baad we'll calculate. Stock of goods, opening and closing both is given, that's our opening stock and closing stock. Debtors is given, both balances are given. Creditors, opening balance is given, closing balance is missing. Cash, opening and closing is given. Summary of cash transactions, receipt from debtors, payment to creditors, carriage inward and carriage outward. Carriage inward jayega trading mein, outward jayega P&L mein. Personal drawings, that's the proprietor's drawings is given. Office expenses paid, purchase of machinery. Okay, so that is why that machinery balance was missing, kyunki isme yahan pe purchase hai. There were some cash sales also during the year. So apart from credit sales, jo hame debtors account se milega, they have also said that there was cash sales. Now cash sales, if it's missing, we'll obviously get it from our cash bank account. Credit purchases for the year are given to us, 21,500. So obviously creditors mein closing balance nahi hai, so purchase diya hai. So that will help us to calculate our closing balance. A provision for discount on debtors is to be made at 1.5%. Okay, so this is the information given to us. Let's quickly begin the sum. First, we are going to fill up our opening statement of affairs as usual. So we have machinery, machinery is given to us as 8,000. Then we have stock. Stock is 5,500. We have debtors. Debtors is 11,000. And on asset side, we also have cash bank balance given to us. And that is given as 2150. And then we have creditors of 3750, jo ki jayega hamare liability side pe. So creditors 3750. Okay, so we have all our assets and liabilities. There is nothing missing over here. I can close this and find my opening capital. So let's take a total. Asset side, first we'll total up. 8,000 plus 5,500, 11,000 and 2150. I get a total of 26,650. Bring that on this side and let's subtract our liability. of 3750, I get 22,900 as my capital. Now we have to empty our opening statement of affairs. ये सारे amounts will go to the second effect हम इसकी देंगे relevant जगह पे post कर देंगे. Machinery, I'll take it to my balance sheet, asset side. So machinery we have 8,000. I'll keep it in the inner column. There is an adjustment for some new purchase. Then we have stock. Stock is our opening stock, 5,500. It will go to my trading account to opening stock, 5,500. Next we have debtors. Debtors ke liye humne account banaya hua hai. So my opening balance goes there. To balance brought down, 11,000. And we have our cash bank. Again, we have an account for that. It's a positive balance. So, on the debit side, to balance brought down, 2150. Asset side empty. Going to the liability side, we have creditors, jiska humne account hai. So, creditors mein credit side pe, by balance brought down, 3750, and capital 22,900, that will go to our balance sheet in the inner column. Capital 22,900. Balance sheet empty. Now we move on to cash transactions. Double effect we'll give for each. Receipt from debtors. You are receiving an amount. So, on the debit side, two debtors, they are paying you the amount and the amount is 40,500. Second effect in debtors, debtors ke credit side pe, by cash bank, 40,500. So, that's done. Payments to creditors. Now it's a payment. So on the payment side, amount is 18,000. We are paying to creditors. So by creditors, 18,000. Second effect in my creditors on the debit side, to cash bank, 18,000. Then we have carriage inward and carriage outward. Okay. Pehle payment mein likh dete hain dono. We are paying expenses. So carriage inward and carriage outward. Amounts are 1500 and 1750. These are expenses. Second effect in my trading for carriage inward, P&L for carriage outward. Leave space for purchases to carriage inward amount is 1500 and P&L will be carriage outward 1750. So we've recorded that. Personal drawings, 13,000. Again, payment hai first in cash bank, credit side, by drawings, 13,000. And it's drawings, it will affect capital. So capital mein minus drawings, 13,000. We can subtract and write the amount down. 22,900 minus 13,000. I have 9,900. Then we have office expenses paid. So again over here, by office expenses. Amount is 12,500. And it's an expense. Second effect will go to P&L. So, two office expenses on the debit side. $12,500. And we also have purchase of machinery. You are paying for it. So, it will come over here. $1,800. So, buy machinery. Asset khareed rahe hum. $1,800. And you already have machinery, isme add ho jayega, plus purchase, 1,800. In this sum, they have not given us depreciation. Agar depreciation hota, to I would have taken it on this total. Okay? And agar purchase ka date diya hai, then you have to break up your depreciation. 8,000 pe pure saal ka, and 1,800 pe jo bhi date hai us par. But yahan pe they've not complicated it by giving you depreciation. So simply the total goes out as the closing balance. Okay. Then they have said there were some cash sales also during the year, which we'll see later on. And they have said credit purchases for the year were 21,500. So in creditors, we are purchasing, so buy credit purchases, $21,500, and I will take it to my trading account, two purchases. Credit, 21,500. Okay. Then they've said provision for discount on debtors. Before that, we have to record our closing balances. Machinery closing balance we found out. Now stock of goods is given. So let's record that. Closing stock hai ye. Stock is 1750. Closing stock, second effect in my trading, I'll leave space for sales. There is cash sales, credit sales, and then we have buy closing stock 1750. We also have been given debtors 12,500. Ye opening balance hai. Closing on the credit side, buy balance carried down 12,500, and I'll take it to my balance sheet inner column because there is an adjustment of RDD. So debtors 12,500. Then creditors closing balance is missing. I'll just write it down. Two balance carried down. We'll come back to that later. Also in my balance sheet, I'll write down, leave some space, creditors, or jab amount dhoondenge, tab we'll write down. And then there is cash. Cash opening balance is on the debit, closing on the credit. So buy balance carried down, amount given is 550. Okay. And it's an asset. I'll take it to my asset. Cash bank balance 550. Fine. So closing balances jitne the hamare paas, we've recorded. Just one adjustment. Provision for discount on debtors 1.5%. So minus again RDD, provision for discount on debtors. That will be 12,500 into 1.5%, I'm getting 187.5. We'll round it off to 188. And the balance we get is 12,312. Okay. Now, this second effect, RDD, it's an expense. So, I will put it on the expense side of P&L. 2 RDD on debtors, 188. So, we have done everything. Now, we have to start closing our accounts. Debtors, opening, closing given, cash given. What is missing is my credit sales. So, let's calculate that. 40,500 plus 12,500. Our total is 53,000. Take it on the other side and subtract our debit of 11,000. We get 42,000 as our credit sales. We'll take that to trading account. Buy sales. We have said in the sum that we have credit and cash sales. So, we'll write both. And credit sales, we just found out 42,000. Okay. Now, in creditors, the closing balance is missing. So, simply close your account and find the closing balance. 3750 plus 21,500. 25,250 is our total. Bring that on this side. And minus your debit of 18,000. You get 7250 as your closing balance of creditors. Let's take that here. 7250. Okay. And then we have cash bank missing. Cash bank mein opening closing dono balance hai. What is missing is cash sales. Clearly bola hua hai, there were some cash sales. So that will come over here. 2 cash sales. I'll close the account and I'll find my balance. Let's take the total of the credit side. 18,000, 1,500, 1,750, 13,000, 12,500, 1,800 and 550. We get 49,100. I'll write that here. And subtract 2150, 40,500. We get 6450, which is our cash sales. Sum mein jo bola tha, I'm taking it as that. So here I get 6450. Now what remains is closing our final account. So we'll start with trading account. This time we will get the GP. So let's take a total of this. 42,000 and 1750. I get 50,200 on the credit side. Let's subtract debits 5,500, 21,500 and 1,500. We get our GP as 21,700. That's our gross profit. We will bring it down to our P&L by gross profit 21,700. Let's take a total and find our net profit. So, both sides total will be 21,700. Let's subtract our expenses. 1,750, 12,500 and 188. We get 7,262 as our net profit. 2 net profit. And where do we take that? That belongs to our proprietor. So, we add it to his capital. Add net profit. Amount is 7,262. I add it to 9,900. We get 17,162. Let's take a total and see if our balance sheet is tallying. total over here is 24,412. And this side 9,800, 1,750, 12,312 and 550. Yeah, it is tallying at 24,412. So every sum, something different is missing. So this just shows how to find those differences. Cash sales yahan par clearly diya tha that it is missing. So I know that cash account jab hum band karenge, what we'll get is our cash sales. So this is how you approach any sum on incomplete records. We'll still do a few more sums in the further sessions. For now, this session is done. Thank you.